Good evening. It's time to begin our services. I'd like to welcome you all on this beautiful evening. It's beautiful because we have the freedom to be here, not because of the weather. We're going to have our fifth Sunday singing and prayer service this evening. We're going to start with James, the opening song. I have some lists. If anyone wants one, hold your hands up. Song leaders, during this first song, if you would like, please come down to the front so we can roll through these. We're going to have some prayers and some scriptures read. Look forward to a good worship service, James.
O Sacred Head.
O Sacred Head, now
God, our Father in heaven, hallowed be thy name. We come to thee at this time, thanking thee for the opportunity to come out and worship thee in spirit and songs. Help us as we sing and praise thy high and holy name, that we'll sing from our heart and listen to the words and apply them to our lives. Help us to love one another and be a good example in this community, that we can sow the seed here in this area, and that maybe it'll end up in good and honest hearts and bring forth fruit. We thank thee for the elders here at Midway. Bless them as they make decisions. Bless them and their families, the deacons, and each and every family represented here, that will serve thee the best our ability, to be a humble servant of thine, to try to be more like our Lord each and every day. Be with us this day. Forgive us of our sins, and bless those that's less fortunate than we are. These blessing petitions we beg in Christ's name. Amen.
If the skies above you are gray, you are feeling so blue. If your cares and burdens seem great all the whole day through, there's a silver lining that shines in the heavenly land. Look, my favorite, see my friend, trust is promised and grand. Sing and be happy, press on to the
song. Sing.
I know.
Aaron asked me if I knew standing by the river, and I said, yeah, I do. But in my experience, I've never led it. I've always sang bass, so I'm not that familiar with the soprano part of it, so you folks are going to have to help out tonight, for sure. And where I'm having trouble in my mind is getting it started, so we'll do the best we can tonight.
Sorry.
Here I stand beside this chilly waters, waiting for my final call. Lead me gently home, Father. Lead me gently home, Father. Lead me gently home.
When my soul's heart ended and hearty days have come, sin no more shall tempt thee. Never
I'm going to read 1 Corinthians 13. Though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I have become a sounding brass or a clinging cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mystery and all knowledge, though I have all faith so that I could remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, though I give my body to be burned, have not love, it profits me nothing. Love suffers long and is kind. Love does not envy. Love does not parade itself, is not puffed up, does not behave unruly, does not seek its own, is not provoked. Evil thinks no evil, does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. Hears all things, believes all things, and hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. But where there is prophecy, they will fail. Where there are tongues, they will cease. Where there is knowledge, it will vanish away. For we know in part, and we prophesy in part, and when that which is perfect has come, then that which is in part will be done away. When I was a child, I spoke as a child, I understood as a child, I thought as a child. But when I become a man, I put away childish things. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then I shall know just as I also am known. And now abide faith, hope, love, these three, but the greatest of these is love.
Stop the fighting.
361, I'll be a friend to Jesus. They try my Lord and Master, with no one to
be reading James chapter 1, verses 1 through 4. James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ, to the 12 tribes which are scattered abroad, greeting. My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations, knowing this, that the trying of your faith worketh patience. But let patience have her perfect work, that you may be perfect and entire, wanting nothing.
What a friend we have in Jesus.
What a friend we have in Jesus. Oh.
Sweet is the song. Let's all stand for this next one. It's going to be the only song we're going to do all four verses of. We got a little bit of a slim crowd because of the weather, so let's all sing out now.
Oh, I'll be reading Ephesians 6, 1 through 4. Ephesians 6, 1 through 4. Children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with promise, that it may be well with you and you may live long on the earth. And you, fathers, do not provoke your children to wrath, but bring them up in the training and admonition of the Lord. Will you pray? Dear God, thank you for this day. Thank you for all the wonderful things you have given us to do. Thank you for allowing us to come out here and learn more about your word. Please be with everyone leading songs tonight, and please forgive us for our sins. In Jesus' name, amen.
Since the love of God is shed,
Christ's blessings on my head,
as you can see on the screen, our invitation song will be While Jesus Whispers to You, While Jesus Whispers to You. So for just a moment, I want to pull out a couple of thoughts from the song that Jeff led for us a minute ago, If That Isn't Love. If That Isn't Love. The first statement I'd like to draw from that song is one that says, He left the splendor of heaven. He left the splendor of heaven. We need to meditate on that. What Jesus left when he came here. A couple passages come to mind. 2 Corinthians 8 and verse 9. Remember the grace of our Lord Jesus. Though he was rich, yet for our sake, he became poor, that through him we might be rich, of course, spiritually. It's a wonderful thought. And I encourage you, as you think about the Lord in your own prayer time, your own meditations, your thoughts, think about what Jesus left. What did he leave? As he prays in John 17, we read about it. We read his prayer, Jesus to his Father. John 17, verse 5. He's in the very shadow of the cross now, and his thoughts are toward home. He says, Father, glorify me with thine own self, Father. Glorify me with the glory that I had and that we shared before the foundation of the world. So much in that verse tells us about our Lord Jesus. He is eternal. He was existing before the world ever was created because he is the Lord. He is the Word. But notice how that he expresses it. Glorify me with the glory. Look what he left. And really what he left is inexpressible. He left the glory that he shared with the Father. over in Philippians 2, 6, he left an equality with God to come here to become man. He never really got back what he had. In 1 Timothy 2, Paul speaks of Jesus in verses 5 and 6. He says there's one God and one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus. Now, as Paul wrote that, of course, he was already back. Jesus was already back in heaven at the right hand of God. But Paul still refers to him as the man. The man. And so he left the splendor of heaven. Let us never forget that. Think about what he left. Think about what he did. And think about where he's at. We read in Philippians 2 that he emptied himself and took upon him the form of a servant and was made in the likeness of man. Being found in fashion as a man, he humbled himself, became obedient unto death, even the death of the cross. Think about what he left, what he did, and now where he is, the right hand of God. We can't be Jesus, but we can follow in his steps, and so nowhere close, as I say this, nowhere close to what he did, but in following his steps, we leave our comforts, humble ourselves, sacrifice our time and our lives and our energy for him, and then he will crown us with that crown, with that glory. And so that statement, he left the splendor of heaven. The second statement from that song I want us to think about is where it says, it was the lonely hill of Golgotha. It was the lonely hill of Golgotha. What made that hill lonely for Jesus? He had, his mother was there and a few others, friends, ladies were there. They were at the foot of the cross. Jesus knew in his mind that his disciples would eventually carry on the work that they did so bravely, so courageously later on. What made it lonely for him up there on the cross? Well, this statement in John 1, 10 through 12, he came unto his own, and his own received him not. That's what made it lonely. Jesus created us. Colossians 1:16. He is before all things, and in him and through him does all things exist. When Jesus came to this earth, when he greeted people, when he saw people, when he thought of people, everybody on earth, these are his people. He created them. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. And not only did they not receive him, not only did many ignore him, not only did many work in opposition to him, but they crucified him. So yes, it was lonely for him up there on that cross, on that hill. Let us never forget how lonely it was. And also remember that he is bearing the sins of many. And in view of that, Jesus cried out, "My God, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?" We probably cannot even begin to imagine how lonely it was for him up there on that cross. So that lonely hill of Golgotha. And then finally this statement. Even in death he remembered. Even in death he remembered. That's an amazing statement. It's a great, very Bible-based statement. Even in death he remembered. It's one thing for a person to praise God while everything is going well. But the real test comes when a person praises God when things are absolutely against you. I don't think I even come close to that kind of faith. Even in death, Jesus remembered. You remembered who he remembered. In Luke 23, we remember him saying these words, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." Jesus is remembering sinners. He's remembering you and I on that cross. He said to the thief, "Today you will be with me in paradise." He remembered a particular sinner, the thief next to him, the thief we call the thief's cross, a cross of repentance, because he did repent. He had turned away from his immoral ways. Jesus knew him. Jesus could read his heart. Jesus said, "Today you will be with me in paradise." Notice the mercy that Jesus shows to this thief. He remembers a particular sinner. Jesus remembers his mother, even in death. John 19. He said it like this. He looked to Mary at the foot of the cross and said, "Woman, behold thy son." And he looked to John and said, "Behold thy mother." He remembered his mother. You cannot replace mother. You cannot replace mom in the home. I wish our world could get back and swallow that again. We think we have discovered something by sending our women into the world and across the world. God is shaking his head in disgust. There's no better role than mom. He remembered his mother in death. Isn't it interesting? He looked to her and he said, "Behold your son." What has Jesus been doing for the last 3 years? He's been walking around teaching everyone and showing everyone that he is the Son of God. And yet at this moment he looks to Mary and says, "I'm your son, I'm still your son. In a sense, I'll always be your son." Was Jesus Mary's son? Yes. Is Jesus the Son of God? Yes. Can I explain all that? No. But I love to wonder about it. I'm amazed at the amazement of it. And even in death, Jesus remembered his Father. He prays to his Father, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." And as we sing this song of encouragement, is that where your faith is? Have you entrusted your body and spirit to the Lord? Have you given yourself over to him? Have you done that at one time and then sort of relinquished your faith? You've given up on your relationship with the Lord. Have you gone back into the world? Are you ready this evening to put Jesus on in baptism and take advantage of all the blessings of that cross and of the resurrection of our Lord? Can we assist you this evening? Make that known right now as we stand together and as we sing. Brother James.
While Jesus whispers to you, "Come, Savior, come," while
me mention a few announcements, and then we will get right back into our service. We'll continue to pray for Liam Owens recovering from his tonsil surgery. Also, Doris Fuller has the flu, and Greenlee is at home with strep throat. We're remembering Myra's mother-in-law, Lois Cook, as she has taken a fall and probably will be in rehab this week. Also, Roger Jones' brother, Price Letson, Decatur Morgan, ICU with congestive heart failure. Praying for Melanie Wilkerson as well. And especially this evening, Ellie. I want to pray for Ellie. She's at home with an ear infection, but also she'll be going to Vanderbilt in Nashville tomorrow. She'll be having a test on her colon Tuesday, but she has to go on up there tomorrow. So let's especially remember Ellie as she goes through this tomorrow. And remember our gathering this Tuesday evening. We're looking forward to that, 7 o'clock. Also, there are several other announcements that we won't get into this evening, but there are several on the sheet, and you heard them this morning. Now, Upsurge says canceled. What is that? Where's the whole, all of it? So, if you want to be part of the lock-in still, your Chris is handling that. Okay, good deal. Good deal. Remember here, how many more songs we got, Jim? How many more songs? Got one more? Okay. Remember during our final song, if you need to partake of the Lord's Supper, those emblems are left prepared in our conference room. And so please make your way back there during this last song. It's good to be together, and let's sing some more.
Let us stand as we sing.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord lift his countenance upon you and give you peace, and give you peace. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be great.
Heavenly Father, we're thankful for this day. It's many blessings. We're thankful, Father, for this opportunity we've had to come out and worship Thee tonight on Lord's Day. We pray, Father, our worship was acceptable in Thy sight. We're thankful for the church that meets here, Father. We pray, Father, our church here continue to grow in truth and in spirit. And pray, Father, that we're thankful for Thy Son, Jesus Christ, who suffered, bled, and died on the cross so we could have hope for eternal life. Pray with us. Father, go with us throughout this week. Keep us safe. Help us remember all good things come from the above. When this life's over, pray, give us home in heaven. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.